Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to find f of x given the function's second derivative. To complete this problem, we'll work backwards and take the integral of the second derivative to find the first derivative, and then the integral of the first derivative to find the original function. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to find f of x if f double prime, or the second derivative of x, is equal to 2/3 x to the 2/3. So, in order to find f of x, the original function, from f double prime of x, or the second derivative, we need to work backwards. What we'll do is take the integral of f double prime of x to find the first derivative, f prime of x, and then take the integral of that to find f of x. If we have the second derivative, f double prime of x, equal to 2/3 x to the 2/3, then to find the first derivative, f prime of x, we'll take the integral of the second derivative, 2/3 x to the 2/3, and when we take the integral, we have to have the corresponding dx notation here. So to take the integral, we'll just use simple power rule, and because we have x to the 2/3 here, we'll add 1 to the exponent, so 2/3 plus 1, or we can say 2/3 plus 3/3 will give us 5/3, so we'll get x to the 5/3, and then we want to take the coefficient 2/3 and divide it by the new exponent 5/3. So 2/3 divided by 5/3, but instead of taking a fraction divided by a fraction, we can say 2/3, and instead of dividing by 5/3, that's the same thing as multiplying by the inverse of 5/3, which is 3/5. So that is the integral of the second derivative, but of course, whenever we take an integral, we have to add c. So we'll get plus c here, and all we need to do is simplify. Notice, obviously, that the 3 in the numerator and denominator here will cancel, so we'll get 2/5 x to the 5/3 plus c, and that is f prime of x, our first derivative function. Now we need to take the integral of that to get back to f of x. So f of x will be equal to the integral of our first derivative function, so 2/5 x to the 5/3 plus c, and of course, as always, our dx notation. Now, in order to take this integral, we'll do the same thing we did last time. We'll add 1 to the exponent, so x to the 5/3 here, we add 1 to 5/3. 5/3 plus 1 will just give us 8/3, so we'll get x to the 8/3. And now we want to take 2/5, the coefficient, and divide it by the new exponent. So 2/5 divided by 8/3 is the same thing as 2/5 times 3/8. So we'll multiply them, and now c we can treat as a constant. This is basically the same thing as saying c times x to the 0 power. X to the 0, or anything to the 0 power for that matter, is equal to 1. So this is the same as saying c times 1, or just c. So by multiplying by x to the 0, we haven't changed anything, but it now allows us to treat this the same way that we did this x to the 5/3 here. We'll just add 1 to the exponent, so we'll get 0 plus 1 just gives us 1, and then we'll divide c by the new exponent, so c divided by 1 is what we'll get. And because we took another integral, we need to account for the constant of integration and add c again. We want to distinguish it because we've already added c, so instead of using c, we'll use the next variable and call it d. So now we just need to simplify this as much as we can to get our final answer. We'll get f of x is equal to 2/5 times 3/8 will give us 6 over 40, which is the same thing as 3 over 20, x to the 8/3 plus cx plus d. And that's it. That is our original function f of x if the second derivative, f double prime of x, is equal to 2/3 x to the 2/3.
So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.